Okay, now we gotta move the right side foot peg. Put all our parts to the side. Now we gotta move this 9/16 exhaust bracket. And then we'll be able to take the slip on off. What I'm going to do is spray a little lube here and shake the pipe a little bit. And we'll get it loose. You just got to shake it so that oil gets in there. Couple taps. Here she comes. Alright, be careful. Now what I'm going to do is pull off the chrome shielding and then we can remove the exhaust. So I removed this bracket, there's a bolt. I removed the exhaust nuts, that's four of them. I removed the exhaust and just dropped it and put it on the ground. And that gave me the clearance so I could take this cover off, which our clutcher cable is attached to. So it kind of worked out good. I'll show you the other side. With that, we gotta take this C-clip off so we can remove this handle. Put the slack back in the cable so we can remove the handle from this perch. And then we will take the cable and thread it through and remove it from the transmission. That was, I grabbed a 1/2 inch and a 9/16, and now I'm gonna put all the slack back into the cable, and that will allow me to remove it from the perch. All the slack is back in the cable, so that makes this real loose. Pop the pin out, that frees up the cable. Take this white clip, pull it out, and now the cable's free. This was the piece with the C-clip. This will supply with your new cable. Even though it looks like pretty much not a problem, I'm gonna just tie a string through here. So we go the same route that this came off. Because if you don't, you could find yourself, this cable could jam up your hole. It really can. You'll be turning the wheel, it'll be stiff, it'll just be a problem. So I'm just gonna use this string to follow it, to thread it through to the back. So now you see what I did. I have the string following the cable, and that will keep me honest. The string flows through the front wing, comes down, and now I have it here. Okay, now with a 3/16 Allen head, everything is loose, and now I can get to this. Okay, what we're gonna do now is we gotta remove this C-clip. And there'll be a ball and ramp, and this will change. When you put this back together, be very conscious. There's a little slash there that feeds it oil. Have that C-clip right there so it feeds as much oil as it can get. Okay, we got the C-clip out. Take the plate up. Now you see there's a little flip it. There'll be three balls. Make sure they're where they need to be. This comes off. These two pieces go to the side. All right, now I got the transmission cover. You have your O-ring right in there. You can put it on your cable and thread it through. You have your pieces here, C-clip, cable hardware. This twists and flips onto this to the cable, which I'll show you. This piece can only go in one way. That there's a slot there, it can only go in right there. So you can take this apart. I recommend that you lay the cable straight out. I put a little I got my O-ring in there with a little dab of Permatex. With this, I put a little thread sealer. I took this all apart so you can feed this through here and get this started by just turning it, because the cable will want to fight you. Now with the cable straight out, now you can tighten this. You got a thread sealer on there. You're not gonna fight the cable. The cable's gonna turn as you're doing it. A lot of people, they'll try to tighten this when it's on the bike. The cable's hung up, and usually you cause damage to the cable. That's it. As we spoke about before, here's the ramp and the three balls. This will help these three balls stay where they need to stay. And the lubrication can't hurt. Now remember, as we spoke, there's only one place it could go in. Perfect. Now, the cable. Remember how this went? And then you turn it. Push the cable in. And that's where you're at. Now, as we spoke before, we want to try to get this where it's facing here, the C-clip. I like doing it from this side because I could drop the thing in. Now you'll notice there's a ring. Put your screwdriver, bring it to it. You'll hear it click. Now that you have that, now try and twist it. Oh, there you go. I bought these Harbor Freight. Not too bad. This one I removed it with S&K. Now we're done. The hole, that's just the way it was. The ring is in the clip and the ramp is in place and everything is all right. Now to reinstall. Okay, I'm gonna tie the string onto the cable. This is the cable that's gonna help guide it to the way Holly had it. All right, I tied the string to the end of this loop. What I'm gonna do is now pull the string and thread it through and it will follow the OEM position. So then we'll have no problems later on. Now we're going to take this gasket and line it up. You'll see there's two dowels. Beautiful. Make sure this is all the way back. Okay, all the way back. You'll notice the two dowels now will hook up to this. Got a shorty. Got a long one. You got the long ones. The two short ones are on the top. Just put them in by hand for now. Star pattern. I just like to snug them up at first, just so I have a little resistance on my wrist. Then you can check the book for torque values. Sealing on here. So that rubber O-ring, you should have no leaks. All right, with a quarter inch, I'm gonna check the ones right on. Oh yeah, should be a little loose. That's all tight. Now this is back together. I took the play out of it. Now I check. I like that. You do it a few times. Do it a few times just to get everything out of the cable. Make sure you got a little eighth inch play for now. Put C clamp back on. Put oil back in transmission. Put exhaust back in place, front fairing on, and bags, and we're done. All right, with that, we're gonna check our transmission oil level. I like to use the Harley Davidson Formula One. You want it right below the F. All right, screw it back in. I'm gonna start her up now. I checked for the fluids. Transmission's filled. I got the exhaust all tightened up. Everything's to where it needs to be. The only thing left are the covers for the exhaust pipes, the front foot peg, and the bags and stuff of that nature. Right now I'm gonna start it up, check for exhaust leaks or any kind of oil leaks before I go any further. I'm pretty sure I'm all right. I check for neutral. Turn the key on. Everything sounds good, clear. Sounds good, no exhaust leaks. I don't see nothing. Oil, I knew I wouldn't see no oil leak. But with that, I'm gonna finish her up. All right, she's all done. If you have any questions, just ask. And have a good day and ride safe.